So before you start customizing your website and making it yours, you need to do a bit of prep work. Now I'm going to give you a quick crash course on choosing fonts and colors for your website that you're going to use when you're making your website look the way that you want it to look. Now, I go over these topics in much more depth in the courses available on my website, but I just want to give you a quick crash course of some resources that you can use to identify fonts and colors that you're going to need to customize your website and make it look how you want it to look. So first off, we're going to talk about fonts, and here's a website I like to go to. It's called fontpair.co, and you can come here and see different fonts and how they look together. Now, typically on your website, you're going to want two fonts or maybe three, depending on how you're going to design your site, but you typically have one font that's your headline, and you would use this for the different headlines throughout your site, and you typically find it in your menu, and then you would also have a font for the body of your website, and then sometimes you might have a third sub-headline font, and this time sometimes you see it's a cursive font and it really kind of draws your eyes to it. So the way fonts work with websites is Google has something called Google Fonts, and it's pretty much integrated into all aspects of WordPress, and you're going to be able to choose these Google fonts with a drop-down menu. So this website actually shows you some really good font pairs. So it's already done that pairing for you. It's kind of like when you go to a fancy steak restaurant and they'll pair the wine to the meat that you're ordering. This is essentially what it's doing, but for fonts. So you can come down here and then you would just scroll down and see the name of the font you'd like. So here's a headline and then here's the body. So the headline is the cabin font and the body font right here is the old standard font. And you can just scroll down and they have font pair after font pair. In fact, I actually recently used this website to find a font pair that I liked for one of my other websites. I really like this Muli font right there. That's nice. So basically, you want to come down here and you want to pick out two fonts, whatever you like. And you don't have to stick with their pair. If you like this headline, but you like this body style right here, you would want to choose Muli and this font right here. And that would be the font that you choose. Now, typically, when you're in the page builder, you're going to be able to choose different thicknesses for the font as well to make it stand out a little bit more. So this is just a little quick crash course to fonts. Now, the next thing you need is colors. And here's a website that I like to go to find colors. Now, if you already have a logo design, typically, you can extract the colors from that logo and go with those colors through the design of your website, but you can also use this website. It's called colors.co. Now there's two O's in it, COOLORS.co. And you can come here and find lots of really neat colors and find the ones that you want to use on your website. And kind of similar, you're going to typically have two colors, but sometimes you might go with three colors. So you're going to usually have your primary color, and that's going to cover about 60% of your website. And then you would have your accent color, and that's going to cover about 30% of your website or 40. Now, if you did want to go with that third color, I like to call it the pop color. It's going to be different from the other two colors, and when someone's on your website, you want to use that color to where you want their eyes to gravitate to. So this could be like a button or a phone number or something like that, or some form of a call to action, and that's the use of that pop color. You don't have to, but you can use that if you want. So you would just come to this website right here, and I like to click on the explore option right there. And when you do that, it's going to show you a variety of color palettes. Now, what we're after is every single color has something called a hex code, and it's the pound sign and six characters after it that can be letters or numbers. And when you get those hex codes, that's what you're going to copy and paste throughout your WordPress website to get that exact precise color. It is these hex codes. So for instance, if I'm here and I like this color palette right there, I would click on view and it's going to open up in a new tab and it's going to generate my colors. I'm going to just click on this X right here and you see there are the hex codes right there. So I can just highlight this hex code and then when I paste this into WordPress, it's going to generate this exact precise color. So you want to get these hex codes. Now you're also going to have, for a lot of the things you do in a page builder, you're going to have a color picker where you can have this dial and you can choose your color that way. But it's very hard to find a color you want. It's really good to come to websites like this that have such a variety of color schemes that are already put together for you that you can really just discover what you like. And that's a lot of the problem with building your own website, is just discovering what you want. And so this is a great tool for that. So these have been two great ways to, one, find fonts and two, find colors. You're going to want them because when you start building a website, you're going to want those color codes and you're going to want those names of those fonts that you want to use in your website.